project building. They blowing them cookies, that's all the ghetto children. Plotting on ways that we can make a million, million. Lord, hood up until then.
Go.
Hood up until then.
Let's get it.
Okay.
Hey man, what's going on behind the scenes, man? Doing it up today for the kids. And a lot of the kids up in there. Me and the young fella right here, man. We put how many kids are there?
It's supposed to be 100. It'll work about 100. Yeah, about 50 right now.
40 or 50. All the popcorn and shit. All the popcorn, all the shit. We show up, man. Y'all show up for the community. The reason why, you know, we film this shit is to show people this is the blueprint of how we do things, how we can get back to our community without having to spend hella money. Simple days, simple things. We go in, we just chill, enjoy it, and we remain staples in our community because we're empowering the next generation of this is the things to do. This is what you, if you get to a level of influence, if you get to a level of position, utilize your position to empower others. We all never know how much some families might be going through. Man, a movie trip, that shit might be too expensive. Somebody may have 4 or 5 kids. That movie trip get expensive for luxury. Some people is on survival budgets. So now if we're in position to go, we're going to fuck the money off from the strip club. We're going to throw it away and whatever. We're in a dice game. We're going to throw it. We're going to mess it up. So why not give it back, man? Take some time out. Just like paying taxes. If you go to church, you pay tithes. You go to church, you pay tithes. There it is.
Yeah, I know.
In our community, let's pay tithes. Let's pay tithes and pay it forward by dealing with these children and dealing with these kids. That's how we pay spiritual tithes. Let's move forward, y'all.
Answer the question.
Happy to be here.
Okay.
All these kids here
and
see the movie. Thank you.
Thank you.
Speaking of that, how you feeling, huh?
I'm feeling great, brother.
We got an event today, man, with the kids, 100 kids. Well, that was the mission to do 100. Probably fell short a little bit, but we did our part.
We feeling? Didn't fall short. We bought the tickets. The kids didn't make it.
Why? How you feeling?
Okay. I'm feeling great, man. You know what I mean?
Kids don't even go to the movies no more.
Huh? Hey! You know, it's always motivates me to keep going and keep striving and doing stuff like this for the kids because when I was a kid, it wasn't nobody already doing this type of stuff on me. So I think that it's a great thing to do for kids because I wish it was done for me.
What's some of the things that inspire you to continue to keep moving forward?
Hoping that in the process when we do stuff like this that maybe I get lucky enough to connect with a kid or two and maybe help him navigate through some of the challenges that I went through. So that'd be my main thing, to get around the kid. Because it takes for you to do something for them to really want to listen to you. If you just come up to them and you ain't doing nothing for them, you're trying to tell them to do this and that, they're not really listening. Right. If I can create a relationship with them at 5 or 6, when they get 15 or 16,
they'll remember that.
So when the parents say, can you talk to my kid, it'd be easier for them to talk to me because they remember some of the things that I did for them before
that. Right.
So that's kind of like one of the main reasons.
What's some of the future goals that you, you know, want to continue to keep going with kids?
I mean, you know, we want to buy this great America. We want to, you know, we want to make it bigger than this. You know what I mean? I want the academy. I just want to continue to give the thing that was absent in my life when I was a kid that might have prevented me from going to prison and using drugs. I try to fill those gaps and maybe I can have a conversation or two. So the trip is cool, but building a relationship with the kid for the future is the main
thing. Words that you want to say to those that are influential individuals in the community, whether it be street boys, hustlers, anything that you want to use to them to about how we could probably use our influence to help change the narrative that these children are doing?
I just think that if more people get involved from all walks of life and we can come together to do these type of things, it creates opportunities for us to sit at the round table and say, okay, it don't matter what you're doing with your life. Let's work together to prevent them from going through some of the things that they had to go through. Because you need all aspects. You need the people coming out the boardroom, and you need to come to the brick room. They come together to make their change. You know what I mean?
Because lights out to the boardroom.
Yeah, but that's what you need.
We'll send it to the strip club.
Yeah.
Love you, man. Popcorn, good to the motherfucker.
Where's the money at, bro?
Huh?
I need some money, man. $2.
Can I get $2?
I'm so bad, man.
But how,
man? Now, you gonna really get me here to do this, man?
I spent all that money last night at the strip club. What with the strippers? With you. So I could be lit. Hey, Khan, we love you. Thank you so much. The whole media team, One Block, our block, my block, the Arab block, all that shit, man. We putting all this thing together. Imagine if we could connected it all, man. And we all connected. East side, west side, north side, Frisco, Berkeley, Richmond, Vallejo, wherever, around the world, so we can begin to spread the importance of, nigga, let's use our influence to help some of these kids, man. Any nigga that's promoting poison to these kids, nigga, use a bitch, straight up. The airway, not the other way.
Broke, you act rich, we both lying. I be grinding, scraping, rental riding. I act broke, you act.